friends of the show and great feminists, Emma Watson and Seth Rogen.
For my new books. The first is Sit, Stand, Bend, all about sitting down for discrimination, standing up for opportunities, and bending back for no one. My next book is Bobbing, Twisting, Pulling, all about bobbing out discrimination, twisting into opportunities, and pulling out during sex. And to my new customer favorite, Milk, Milk, Lemonade, Around the Corner, Fudges Made, all about milking opportunities, lemonading your coworkers, and fudging your raise during negotiations. Wow. All right, well, I hope you are there having an incredible time. You're only a hop, skip, and jump away from female empowerment.
Yeah. I was there for a week with you and a Seth.
So you were taking English?
Oh, gosh, it changed my life.
Was this Greenwich Village?
They wanted
it. They wanted it.
Another $20 bill, because the real president of this country is money.
Money. Speaking of this country, weird things are happening outside our own country, okay, people? Yes, that is right. A woman in Germany is giving birth to quads, and she is 65.
Wow.
She already has 13 children.
What?
Come on!
I know. Have you been to Germany?
I might have.
Oh! Do you just have a memory?
You know what? Speaking about this lady, I'm a life coach. I encourage people to reach for their goals.
Sure.
But there are no successful people. Research shows that the only successful people are people who moisturize, they wear sunscreen, many of them put on a serum before bed. How can you possibly make time for self-care if you have 13 children and counting?
As someone who's married herself, at least she's still...
What's in the cup holder?
Put it down. 65 and she's still...
Day by day with people marrying people, people marrying dogs, people marrying trees, people marrying dirt. Put her on the $20 bill. I'll sign off on it.
She's German.
Well, as someone that likes to keep it real, keep it 100, keep it honest all the time, this woman is not doing that, okay?
Whoa.
Because a 65-year-old woman who's pregnant with four kids is just not keeping it real, okay?
That's true.
And I have a problem with that.
Are you against, like, total artificial insemination, in vitro, like,
even,
not...
Is it real?
I am offended by that.
I have frozen all five of my dead husband's sperm, and I'm just waiting for the day.
Yeah.
There's nothing realer
Yeah.
3 pounds.
Yeah.
Fun fact. I got a fun fact for you.
Fun fact.
Yeah. Fun fact. UNICEF is actually, we are actually in a partnership with them, so hashtag save the word, hashtag I'm no angel.
Hey. You can look at that size lingerie. Is working with UNICEF?
Yeah.
If you can tell me anything about
women
UNICEF,
who are natural.
You can say anything about the organization UNICEF and what it does.
The president chief and I went to dinner last night.
President chief?
Where?
President chief.
Everyone's favorite recording artist, Nelly.
Definitely mine.
Was recently arrested for possession of meth, marijuana, drug paraphernalia, and weapons.
Where was I?
Yes. Should all drugs be legalized?
Yeah. Should they? I don't really know why it begs that question.
As somebody who has, yes, experience in the music industry.
Sure.
I was on American Idol. No, I don't want to talk about it. I just have to say that musicians are often villainized because they're such heroes, and people are threatened by that. And it's like, when you've worked so hard and you're just judged, and they just throw you out like you're garbage, like you're some drug addict.
She's speaking to Tessa.
It's just a contest. I still hear Ryan Seacrest in my nightmares.
Oh, no. We all do.
He's dead.
I change my therapist every time they refuse to give me medication. I feel like, who isn't on drugs, right?
I can tell you a few. If I were to keep it real, which I like to do all the time, I keep it real, I do drugs.
Okay. Speaking
of keeping it real, guys.
Yeah.
Gwyneth
Paltrow.
Oh. I hate her. I don't know why, but I hate her.
I spent many nights drinking a lot of Italian wine together, and I love her. But she's, you know, she's getting a little bit of a flack recently. She's living off of $29 a week in support of people on food stamps who struggle to make ends meet.
Oh. Yeah, Jamie, did you see that? It was on Facebook.
And people just hate her. They hate her.
You slow the fuck down.
My question is, what do you all do to keep it real with poor people?
Okay.
I touched one on the way in.
I change my cell phone carrier every month because I, you know, they track you. So one time I had T-Mobile and that was.
Oh wow.
It was rough.
I have lived on the streets. Bo Bice and I were. We were down and out, and we went to Constantine Morales' house, and he closed the door. We went to Carrie Underwood's house, she closed the door, and we had nowhere else to turn. Me and Bo Bice.
You can't go to people's houses and get invited, even if you were on American Idol.
She's making it
back. I don't want to talk about American Idol!
Okay, sorry.
Guys,
I had Burger King last night.
To be honest, I like to keep it real, keep it 100, keep it honest all the time. I don't do poor shit. No, thank you, right? I keep it real. I am bougie, and that's how I am, and I can't change it.
Shallow
Hal,
and I got there.
She mentioned you.
She did not. Did she really?
No.
let me also eat off of the SAG table, and she's always had this like good-natured aspect to her. Mm. I don't know why I can't get union. I know so much.
If I can jump in,
paperwork issue.
Here's the thing: instead of having rich people eat what poor people will eat for a week, let's give the poor people the rich people's food and see what they can get to, you know?
Yeah.
So they can say, oh, I can get there.
Beautiful.
Oh,
wow. All right, guys, so those were some seriously hot flips. So we know springtime is right around the corner, or it's here, and
it's here.
We need to refresh our catchphrases, obviously. So we're very excited to bring out our next guest. He is on the pulse of millennial culture. He has a strong Google SEO presence.
Do you know what those words mean?
No. And he's going to give us some new catchphrases for the spring. So everyone, please welcome Pat Regan.
Retiring our spring catchphrases. I'm saying goodbye to, this is going to be the most productive summer of my life. And which were my two springs.
Never.
Get it out. Get it out. Get it out.
Get it out.
Will
you get it out?
Will I take it?
I'm not a pro.
Catchphrases could be nonverbal.
Oh, I love
them. So I get a lot from my clients, you know, they say, Pat,
yeah.
What makes a good catchphrase?
Sure.
And I say thank you for asking before you fuck up. So you want your catchphrase to be kind of underlining on your personal brand for that season. What are you trying to accomplish? Who do you want to be?
Right.
Secondly, it should be sassy and fun.
Oh, that's
fun.
That's
so fun.
So I'm kind of taking the liberty to pitch a few to a couple of my favorite gays girls. To try out maybe for this summer.
Oh, that's great.
Love
it.
I'm only for a couple more months.
Okay.
All right. So, Amanda, I understand that you have had so much plastic surgery that you've been technically dead.
Yes, for 15 minutes, but now I'm back.
Sure. Well, how about these three options? I'm so hot I'm dead. Don't, do not revive. Or donate that face to someone who needs to donate their face and get a new one. Asking you to do some kind of work or labor, you can say.
Poor people.
Right. Staples are for stomachs. I don't do office supplies.
That's the one. I have so many in here. I can't eat right.
Then it's funnier.
Okay,
Pat, give Amanda a situation and then she'll do it.
Okay, sure. You're at Starbucks ordering a chai latte.
Oh, can I do the play with her?
Yes.
Okay.
Good job.
You're not the first one. Excuse me. How about you donate that face? Right?
Yeah.
And there's a second part, right?
That's it.
No, just
it.
Donate that
face. Oh, here's a great latte.
Okay,
I think the play's over.
I think the play's over.
This is so weird being at the front.
Sure.
Are you okay?
Yeah, it's just I'm so aware of everyone.
Okay. Hi.
How about this for you, Lydia?
Okay.
I was a child star. I can be crazy. You know what I mean?
Not for a shirt? I could say a shirt?
Oh, catchphrases are terrific for a shirt. So if you're out here summer catchphrases on a shirt, put that summer catchphrase on a shirt.
Or a hashtag.
Yeah, like at the end of a tweet.
Or on a basket. Put it on a
basket.
Like, but
first of all, thank you for just saying I was a child star. That means a lot. A lot of people don't think the people in the background are stars,
well,
but we shine. Right.
They sent that over to me. They sent that over to me. They told
okay.
me.
That was your take on my career. That was what
yeah,
they
said.
Yeah,
we beefed up your resume.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah. Resume.
Yeah, I could be crazy.
Yeah, there you go.
Yeah.